Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. I know it's been a couple weeks since I made a video, but I'm glad to make this video specifically because I took my final of my first quarter at Booth. And lo and behold, today I'm going to talk about what I learned during my first quarter at Booth. I think talking about every single quarter as my MBA experience goes on in my YouTube channel might be helpful for you guys and could give you some perspective whenever you're thinking about if you want to pursue an MBA or if you want to do an MBA in a similar fashion like I'm doing, where I'm traveling to a location and doing my MBA studies every weekend while maintaining a full-time job. This is for you. Before we get to the content, please be sure to like this video. Subscribe so you can get more content in oil and gas and professional development topics. And please be sure to comment on the video below on the YouTube platform so I can incorporate your feedback into future videos. Please be sure to hit that notification bell because I upload whatever I want. Well, let's get to the content. At University of Chicago Booth School of Business, we call this launched whenever we start a new quarter or the very first quarter of your MBA studies. Therefore, I launched in the spring of 2022. Therefore, from April up until the end of May, I was traveling to Chicago once a week, taking connecting flights, and I would come back on Saturday night and spend the rest of my weekend in Midland. So today I'm going to talk about what are some of the things I learned during my first quarter at Booth. The first thing I'm going to talk about is taking the big elephant in the room, and I'm going to address it right here and there, is the travel. You get used to it. I have a system where I have separate bags, one for work, one for travel, one for the gym, and I prepare each one of them throughout the week. Because I'm able to have the system, it's no big for me to travel once every week to Chicago to pursue my studies, to pursue my dream, to say the least, and then come back in after 24 hours. Therefore, if you want to do the MBA program similar to like myself, I can guarantee you that as someone who's taking connecting flights to go to Chicago, it is worth it and you can get used to the travel. And if you live in a larger city than I do, such as Houston, where you could take a direct flight to Chicago, don't be making any excuses that you can't do it. Now, if you have any excruciating circumstances or anything like that, I completely understand. But if I can do it, I'm trying to encourage you that you can do it too. The next thing I'm going to talk about is another obvious thing when it comes to going to a competitive MBA program. Everyone's really smart. I have intense imposter syndrome. When I got into Booth, I got really excited and I made a video about it. You can check out the video on my channel. And it built the confidence in me that maybe I have that caliber to go to a really good MBA program. But as I got into the program, started pursuing my studies, I've seen a whole nother level of smart when it comes to people of all sorts of backgrounds. This reminded me of whenever I entered university, pursuing petroleum engineering, going to the University of Texas, and realizing I wasn't the smartest kid in the classroom. Wasn't necessarily a humbling or crushing moment for me because I went to a very competitive high school, but it was a reminder that the imposter syndrome does creep up and I have to be confident in myself that I am also smart and I'm also among the smart people that got into the MBA program. So I had to keep reminding myself that. But everyone is extremely smart. An average person at Booth is an extremely smart person, I would say. And I figured that out when I looked at how people performed on midterms, how people performed on finals, for example. At least these are anecdotes that I've heard from other Booth students. Knowing that the amount of hours that they put into studying and getting the score that they get, it made me realize why Booth professors have to curve these grades like they have to. They have to make these exams extremely difficult because you're graded on distribution. But I wanted to share with you that everybody is smart at Booth and my imposter syndrome does creep up from time to time. The next thing I want to talk about is, well, I'm not the only one with imposter syndrome. I had a wonderful moment where I hung out with a few Boothies a few weeks ago before my Saturday classes. I got a chance to hang out with them, hanging out with them, meaning we may have bar hopped. And when we were doing that, we had a very in-depth conversation about the imposter syndrome and how we all have it. Well, not everybody at Booth has it, but the people in the group that I was talking to, they all have it. And we all had to remind ourselves that we got into the program, we are of that caliber, and it's okay to be below average in the class because you're still among one of the smartest people. And when I talked to my husband about the imposter syndrome, I realized that he has it too from time to time. So I learned that a lot of people do have the imposter syndrome. I'm not the only one who has it. And I realized that a lot of people at Booth have the imposter syndrome as well. And even though they're proving themselves to be extremely intelligent people, they also have that inner voice telling them, or inner critic telling them, whether if they are of that caliber or not. And I realize everybody is their own worst critic. So I learned that I have to be pretty nice to myself and I have to be nice to other people. Having that in mind with the fact that a lot of people have imposter syndrome at Booth. Another thing I learned about is the camaraderie at Booth. You get to be friends with a lot of people who you end up traveling with. Let me give you some context. At Booth, you have these shuttles. So when you're done with your classes on Saturday, there are free shuttles to take you to the airport, whether it's O'Hare or Midway. And in your shuttles, you're with other Booth students, and during the ride to the airport, you're really anxious together. You're talking about your classes together. Other Boothies are giving advice to others, and you truly bond. So you bond with your travel mates whenever you are at the university and doing the weekend program. And I really enjoy that because I'm making a lot more friends. I'm having a wider network than I could even imagine. I'm in a ton of WhatsApp groups and a bunch of Slack groups from people at Booth. For some odd reason, I'm in the Houston Slack group, and it could be because I'm the only one in Midland. But what I'm trying to say is that you do end up making a lot of friends, even though the weekend program is very fast. And it seems like the weekend program, you don't get to spend as much quality time with other students because you're in and out all the time. Next thing I want to talk about, and I've already alluded to this in my previous point, that the quarter goes really fast. 2 months goes really quick. And the fact that they've made the quarter short, the Booth made the quarter shorter to 9 weeks, makes it even more intense. Not only do professors have to cut material, but they have to cram the material. So it's new material that you're learning along with the pace of the course. That's what adds the intensity to the program or to the entire MBA experience. Therefore, you have to be on top of your things. You have to stay organized. That's why I have separate bags for travel, for the gym, and for work prepared throughout the week. That way I have a system down and I make it easy on myself. Because it's really easy to get unorganized or to be behind a week or two if you're not on top of your game when you are in a very fast quarter system and you're traveling at the same time. Therefore, my piece of advice to you, especially if you're in the quarter system and you're going to pursue MBA studies, is that you have to stay organized and it goes really fast. Start your homework on the plane ride back to your destination. I'll talk about something a little bit light. What I learned during my first quarter at Booth is Chicago is an amazing town. Funny enough, I actually never visited Chicago before. And my first weekend at Booth was the first time I visited Chicago. You might be wondering, Yoshi, how did you even get the time to experience Chicago if all you were doing was going to class and going home? Well, my husband was there with me during my first weekend, and I also spent Memorial Day weekend in Chicago as well. When I spent Memorial Day weekend, I was able to explore the city a little bit more, breathe a little bit more, and enjoy the town. I really enjoy Chicago, full of culture, great food. I love the deep dish pizza. And it's no wonder that a lot of my classmates want to move to Chicago as they pursue the weekend program. Personally, that's not something that I want to do. I'm still staying in the oil and gas industry after obtaining my MBA, but I wanted to get a traditional MBA, and you can check out my previous video on how I got into Booth, the application process, for more information on that. But I did want to talk about something light in that Chicago is a great town, and I really enjoyed the town during my first quarter. Last thing I'm going to talk about in terms of what I learned during my first quarter at Booth is other professors are traveling as well. Turns out my business statistics professor comes from Texas and he flies to Chicago every week to teach the business statistics class. I used to think these professors have no empathy for students that are traveling every weekend from all over the United States to attend a world-class MBA program. Turns out, professors are doing the same. And that really builds my motivation quite a bit to pursue the program, to pursue this dream. It's a beautiful thing when you see people from coming from all over the place for pursuing their studies. The funniest analogy I can think of is people coming from all over the world to attend ACL, Austin City Limits, like going to a concert, for example, and then being bonded by music. It's weird, but that's the same way how I feel about the MBA program, people coming from all over the world and attending class. Take that as you will. But what I want to say is my motivation is built up more than ever before, knowing that it is not just students that are traveling around the world to attend class, but it's professors, it's faculty, it's other people that are making the weekend program at Booth a possibility. And that's a wrap, everyone. Those are all the things that I wanted to share of what I learned in my first quarter at Booth. I hope this gives you some perspective in pursuing your MBA studies while maintaining a full-time job if you're going to do the travel. I do want to mention about the travel and that it can be exhausting sometimes, and I'm really glad I'm taking two classes instead of three. If you remember in my previous videos, I did talk about arguing with my husband whether if I wanted to take three classes versus two so I can plow through the MBA. But it turns out two classes is just enough. And in fact, I have just enough hours in the day to complete two courses for per quarter. Anyway, thanks for watching this video. Be sure to subscribe, like this video, and hit the notification bell because I upload quite often. Thank you so much for watching this video, and I'll see you in the next one.